So when we are going to see the connections between the processor and the memory, like we'll be going to have the main memory which is connected to memory address register and everything what I have shown. So here when we are going to talk regarding this connections between the processor and the memory, this need to be done very much carefully. The instruction should be forwarded from one unit to another unit in a very much careful manner, fine. Until unless if you are going to do it correctly, our instruction will not be processed in a right way. So here first we will be going to discuss regarding this different resistors seen over here, fine. What are the different resistors seen over here? Here we will be going to have the memory address register. So MAR in the sense memory address register. So memory address register, what the purpose of this is, it holds the address of the location to be accessed. So suppose I want to access some X address, X location. So that address is going to be accessed by this memory address register. And next one is memory data register. So it contains the data to be written into or read out of the address location. That is the memory data register. And it comes to program counter. This program counter holds the address of the next instruction to be executed. So that is the program counter. And the instruction register. What this instruction register is going to do is it is going to hold the instruction that is currently being executed by the CPU. So that is the instruction register. Control unit, as we all know, ALU we all know. And here we'll be going to have the resistors R0 to Rn-1. So all these resistors we call it as a general purpose resistors. So here we'll be going to see how one processor and the memories are going to be communicated and in order to do a particular operation. Suppose any instruction, I'll be going to take the instruction add LOC A comma R0, fine. What this instruction is going to say, add the contents of LOC A to the contents of R0, and finally the result is going to be stored in the R0, fine. Initially the program reside in the memory. Like here, what is the thing? This we have to reside in the main memory. Why? Because CPU will communicate only with the main memory but not with any other different types of memory. So that's the reason we have to store this instruction in the main memory only. So this is the program. Here we are having the three instructions, 1, 2, 3 instructions. So when will be the execution is going to start, in the sense whenever our PC is set to the first instruction, then the execution is going to be starting, fine. It should not be in the fifth instruction or it should not be in the sixth instruction. It should be only in the first instruction. Whenever it is going to have in the first instruction, then only we'll be going to have the execution to be started. So this is how the execution process is getting started. So make sure that the PC should be in the first, should point to the first instruction. So fine, then only the execution is going to be started. Next, what is the thing is, the contents of this PC are transferred to the memory address register. So what are the contents of the PC? Program counter is going to have the contents of the instruction, which address of the instruction. So this instructions are transferred to the memory address register, fine. And a read control signal is sent to the memory. After transferring the contents to memory then we'll be going to send a read signal to the main memory. After the time required, after some time gap, what it will be going to do is, this address word is read out of the memory and loaded into MDR. So from here we have sent a read signal now. From here, this instruction is going to be loaded into MDR. So MDR is the memory data register. Now this MDR data, the contents of the MDR are transferred. Where it is going to transfer? It is going to transfer to the instruction register over here. And now the instruction is ready to be decoded and executed. Till now the instruction is not been decoded. When the contents are going to be transferred from MDR to instruction register, here the contents are going to be decoded in the memory instruction register. If the instruction involves whatever the instruction we have sent over here, if this instruction is having any arithmetic and logical operations, then it is necessary to obtain the required operations here in the ALU. Fine. An operand in the memory is fetched by sending it address to the memory R. So when the operand has been read out of the memory to the MDR, it is transferred to the memory to the ALU. So if it needs any arithmetic and logical operations, it is going to be sent over here. After one or two repeated cycles, what the ALU is going to do is, the ALU is going to perform the desired operation. So address of the location where the result is stored, that address is again, it will be going to store in the MAR register. Why? Because MAR register is going to store the address only. Fine. So after storing the result in the final address in the MAR, the contents of PC are incremented. Why? Because previously it was 1000. So whatever the contents that are going to be there in the 1000, that instructions we have done. Now the address is going to be stored in the memory address register. Now next instruction has to be executed. Now so the contents of the PC are loaded with the next instruction address. So these are the instructions that are going to be followed when we are going to have or we are going to execute any particular instruction. And remember that instruction register, what is the main task of the instruction register is, what is the instruction that is currently executed by the CPU, that instruction it is going to holds the instruction that is currently being executed. What is the use of this program counter? The program counter keeps track of execution of the program. That is the first thing. It contains the memory address of the next instruction to be fetched and executed. Suppose this is the order X, Y, Z. If X is executing currently, what the memory PC is going to have? It is going to have the address of Y, next instruction. After X, which instruction needs to be executed? This Y instruction needs to be executed. So after X, this Y instruction need to be executed. So this Y address is going to be stored onto the program counter. Address register holds the address. Memory data register holds the data. And control register sends the control signals. ALU, if any arithmetic and logical operations are there, that is going to be performed by the ALU. This is how an instruction is going to be executed. And what are the connections between the processor and the memory? That is also we have shown over here. First, the contents of the PC are going to be transferred to the contents of address register. So whatever the address that is specified in the address register, we have to search in the memory. We know the address. In that address, what data has been stored, that we will be going to search in the memory. So searching in the memory, that address data is going to be sent in the data register. So after sending the data to the data register, we will be going to have this data is going to be sent to the instruction register. Why? Because that is the currently executing instruction. So these many steps are needs to be followed in execute a particular instruction. Fine. So this is how these instructions are going to be executed. So the theory of what I have explained is going to be over here. So this is how all the instructions are going to be done in this by making use of the memory address register, data register, program counter, instruction register, arithmetic and logical unit and control unit. These many registers needs to work together in order to perform a single operation. Fine. this is how the execution is going to be taking place. That's it all for students for today. In the next class, we'll be going to coming with the next other topics of the first unit. Fine. Go through the videos, and if you are going to have any doubts, like, you can ask me. Fine. Thank you. Thank you, students.